Hey gang, so in that last video we were working on making this scoreboard, and a scoreboard is going to want to have a score, isn't it? So let's add a score. Hopefully maybe you already thought of this yourselves. And let's add a render method. And in that render method we can sure hate that when VS Code wants to help me but doesn't. We're gonna, now this, I'm not gonna make these game options, because it's just never gonna change, but, so I think I'm just gonna go ahead and hard code these, because I'm feeling kind of lazy, and I don't want to take up too much of your time. So there is a great function in P5 called text. So we've got our fill, which is the color inside of our text. We've got our stroke, which is the outline. And then we can make this text, and we can say, so this will be a string that'll appear on the screen, and I'll give it a position. We could come back maybe and turn these into settings if we want to, or you can do it. It's up to you. So this is going to be the X position, and this will be the Y position. We can also change the font size if we want to. I'm just going to keep with the default, but we got that render method now, and I'm going to take a look. I need to restart this. Open with live server. And still not working. What did I do? Scoreboard is not defined at new game. So you know what I forgot to do. I've got my scoreboard here. I don't have my scoreboard here. All right, so I got my scoreboard. We also got to make this overlay, and let's see, what else do we need to do? Let's just see what's happening. Okay, we got our score. I don't know if I like that size. Where am I going to do that? I think that is going to, maybe these are going to need to be game settings. Let's see, scoreboard. Let's call this font size, I think it is. Let me just think. We'll call it text size. I'm cheating. I'm looking at the version I already made. Text size will be 30. And what we could do is say, let's just do it. So we'll say text size. Here I was saying I'm not going to put these in, but. And what's nice then is we can actually use. And so we'll just give it, it's just on the Y, it'll just be that a little extra padding. And this will be, so we'll just cheat it a little bit, and we'll say, let's just see what we think of that. And you know, sort of these are pretty just binary. Doesn't matter. So they're not too bad. Score 0. I think we probably want this to be over a little bit more. Game settings that x size times 4.5. There we go, that's better. So we got our score. Cannot read properties of undefined reading width at mario.render p5 image. Now that's Mario 64, so let's take a look at what's going on there. Oh, I think maybe we gotta fix that. So let's see. Mario 64. This dot size, this dot x, this dot size. So we got position object. Let's go to our game where we're declaring our Mario. Game settings dot hero size. Okay, let's figure out why we should be calling this. We should be seeing our coins. Let's hold off on this and see if we can get that to work. Undefined reading render at game.render game.33. Okay, so start screen and game over screen are some screens we need to make. Let's make those first. And you know what? I was just instinctively writing new start screen, but what we can do is basically our start screen and our game over screen are going to be kind of the same thing, but they're just going to be different versions of the same thing. So one is going to be an overlay that we'll give certain values to, and one is going to be an overlay that we give other values to. And the things we need to give in there are going to be some text and also a button. And I think what I'll do is talk about that button in a next video, but because I want to get a little bit deeper into it, but we're going to have a start button and we're going to pass it in here. So we'll pass into our start screen two lines of text, and we'll pass into this game over screen two lines of text and the start button. And I'm going to talk about this in the next video. So let me actually pause this video now, but because I think I want to make this into a separate video, and I will see you in the next video. We're going to do something that's going to be a lot like our scoreboard, except it's taking text in. So if you want to give that a shot right now at what this might look like, this overlay, we'll use some text. See if you can make it happen. And I'll do that with you in the next video, where I'm also going to talk about this thing called the DOM and how P5 works.